Welcome to InfoGamer, my name's Mark, and I want to show you guys how to create the bomb that goes in the Zelda games. The one Link carries around and throws at enemies. It's going to be pretty awesome, and anybody can do this. So, let's get started and show you how to make the game object. Okay, so I've got a project, a Unity project window open, and there's a couple assets I've created in previous videos, like how to create a death zone, how to create a King of the Hill zone, but we don't need to pay any attention to those for this video. You might just want to create a plane, which you can do. This I renamed ground, but right click, create 3D object plane for the floor. Where is it? Right there. Okay. And then you can rename it ground and zero out the transform over here. Okay, let's start creating our bomb. Right click, create 3D object and go to sphere. And let's make sure that this, let's rename this bomb first. Okay, and let's go to the transform and make sure this transform zeroed out. And we can put 0.5 in the Y to bring it up. Then let's grab a material. And I've already created a materials folder in a previous video, but right click create folder and rename it materials, and then you'll have one, a materials folder. You also want it to be in the assets folder right here. So you can double click in the materials, right click create material, and then let's select a nice blue color because that's what color Link's bomb is. It's a bit darker as well too. Okay, that color should be fine. Now that we have that created, we want to create a couple children game objects to this bomb. Right click, create 3D object, cylinder, and let's change the scale to 0.2 in the X, 0.3 on the Y, and 0.2 in the Z. Let's drag this up. Okay, that might be a little bit small, so let's change it to 0.3 in the X and 0.3 in the Z. Okay, this is going to be the top part of our bomb, and we want to change the color, create, so right click, create material, just like we did for the first one, and I selected flare instead. So create material, let's pick a nice silver for this, or gray color, and right there is probably good, and click and drag that onto your bomb. Okay, now that we have that created, it's time to create the rope. So let's go ahead and duplicate this one, and let's rename it rope. Okay, let's change this to 0.2 or 0.02. because it's going to be, no, it's actually 0.05 that we want. 0.05 in the X and 0.05 in the Z scale. Then we can drag up our fuse to whatever height we want. But right there is probably good. And let's change the color of that fuse. So let's create a new material. Right click, create material. Boom, boom, boom. There we go. And let's change this material color to brown, and that's in between yellow and orange, so you can come to this bar and drag it over here, and that will probably do for our brown color. You can then click that and drag it on to our rope. All right, that's all you need to do to create your Link bomb game object. Now we're gonna add effects to this in upcoming videos on this playlist. We're going to add a blink effect to the bomb, so we'll start blinking faster and faster when the bomb's getting closer to blow up. We're also going to add a flame effect up here so that it will burn the fuse down and get closer to the bomb as it gets closer to blow up as well. And then we're going to add an explosion effect. I hope you guys enjoyed creating your Link bomb. In future videos, we are going to learn so much stuff about explosions and effects on things to make them look like they're actually happening in the game. Like right now, it just looks like a plain bomb. There's no way it's going to blow up because we don't have any effects or scripts added to it. But we are going to show you all that and we're gonna try to explain it as easy as possible so anyone can do this.